Hey everyone, I'm Ishan Sharma, and in this video, I'll be talking about the five applications that I have been using every single day as a college student, as a content creator, and as a person who runs a content creation agency. Okay, so I'll take you through every single app. I'll show you how I like to use it, and then that will help you become more productive. That will also help you manage your time in a better way. Okay, so we'll do all of that. Make sure that you hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. And now let's get started. So the first application that I have in my list is going to be Notion. Okay, so Notion, if you don't already know, is a great tool that you can use to basically write down your notes. There are a lot of applications of Notion. I'll be showing you those. All right, so as you can see, this is my Notion homepage. This page is called as the My Links page. I like to put in all of the interesting articles that I have been reading in the past couple of days, and then I just look through them whenever I want to, you know, learn something new. So as you can see, I was looking at this article by Aman Goyal on machine learning, on how people can get started with machine learning. As you can see, I converted that from his blog website to this Notion page, and I can just read it whenever I want to in a much better way, and I can also avoid all the advertisements that are there on the website. Same is the case with this Bill Gates book recommendations. This was actually an article that I converted into a Notion page. Then, you know, you can just like go on and on over here. Whenever I feel low in life, I just write on a Notion page about how I'm feeling. Then there's also this physics lab comprehension preparation that I was doing in my first semester in college. So I just write on whatever is required for these experiments right here. Similar is the case with chemistry lab compre. Then we get to some more depressed times. As you can see, I like to write a lot. Then we get to the YouTube part. Okay, so whatever you know, videos I need to put in, that go into this YouTube planner. Okay, so as you can see, I have divided them into like a project management version. So we have the video ideas, then we have the recorded, then we have the edited, and then we have the live on YouTube. That's basically what I do. As you can see, I have listed all of the videos that I have been putting out recently. Now we get to the to-do part, right? So this is the part in which I just write down whatever tasks I have, what are the tasks that are needed to be done, and then I just start working on them. Okay, then we go to the Unacademy page. This is a calendar, as you can see, and over here I've noted down all the classes that are needed to be taken by me on the Unacademy platform. So that's what this is going to be about. Then we get on to some takeaways. So what I do is that whenever I look at any podcast or any audiobook, I like to write at the same time, right? So this is an example. This was a Clubhouse, you know, session done by Naval Ravikant, and he was just talking about how to get rich slow. Okay, so I just noted down whatever he was talking about in this Notion page. As you can see, you have multiple options on how you can make it better, how you can make it more visually appealing. So yeah, this is what you can do. Let's move on to the next part. This is the work. Again, all the videos that are needed to be done are put up over here. Okay, so I just keep making more and more of these project management Kanbans, I think that is what they call it. Then we have again the compre schedule, whatever exams that need to be given, then books I have read, then we have some more of these project management tools. That's basically how this thing works out. Okay, so this is an example of how I listen to an audiobook, and I also start converting that audiobook into actionable advice, right? So all of these things, I was recently listening to this audiobook called as Brands and Bullshit, and I just tried to note whatever I am learning. Okay, so that's what I did over here. That's about this. Let's move on. This is basically how I use Notion. Let me also show you how people can use Notion if they want to collaborate with other people. So I want to show you what we do with MarketUp at Notion. This is the brand. Obviously, I cannot show you the name and the logo of the brand because that is confidential. This is the part in which we put in the video name. This is the part in which we put in the link of the video that needs to be edited. Then we have the edited by, so the person that is editing the video. And then we have the status. That is basically like, is the video published or not? Okay, that's basically how this happens at MarketUp. We can just assign this video to an editor, or whatever task we need to get done, we can assign it to different people. And that's how we work on Notion in a collaborative way. If you want to use Notion, I'll drop the link in the description. You can check that out. Thank you, Notion, for sponsoring this video. And now let's continue with the second one. So let me open up Canva right here. As you can see, this is canva.com. If you don't already know, I have been using Canva from the last 2 years, I would say, and I've had an amazing experience using this platform. I have also made a video talking about how you can start freelancing on Canva. So yeah, you can just like look at the designs that I have on this website. Pretty much whatever I want to get done, I use Canva for doing that. Okay, so that's how that works out. All of my thumbnails, right? All of my thumbnails are done on Canva. The best part is that you don't need to be an expert in design to get started, and you can still make some pretty good designs, okay, as a beginner. So that's how that works. I have all of the thumbnails that I have made for my channel, all of the graphics that I produce for my Instagram are done solely on Canva. Okay, so I do not use Adobe Photoshop. I know how to use it, but I prefer to use Canva because it's just faster, and that is what I think is of prime importance to me. Now you can edit your thumbnails, you can edit your videos, you can put in background sound as well if you want to, but that is basically how this works out. Okay, the best part here is that you get a lot of templates that you can use. You can just like customize quickly and no one will be able to tell if this is a template or not. So that's the benefit of using Canva over other applications that I use. Another important mention would have to be Adobe Spark Post. That is also a great tool that I use to make whatever IGTV or IG Reel videos I make, the thumbnails for that, or just some simple IG stories that I make. I use Adobe Spark Post for making those, so that's how that works out. Before we move on, it would be great if you can hit the like button. It really helps me out a lot and it is completely free. Thank you so much. Okay, this is going to be my second application, Canva, as well as Adobe Spark Post. The third one will have to be investment applications. There is no one app that I use for this, but there are like multiple applications that I use, right? So number one, we have Upstocks. That is what I use for my stock trading. Demat account I have made using Upstocks. Secondly, we have WazirX. That is what I use for trading in India in cryptocurrencies. The third one would be Grow for investing into mutual funds. I just like their UI. So that's why I use that. After that, we also have other applications, like we have IndMoney and there are some other ones, but this is what I basically use for investing. Now let's move on to the fourth application that I use, and this is going to be Google Calendar. So let me show you how I like to use Google Calendar, and then you'll understand why am I so productive right now. Okay, as you can see, for college, all of the classes that I have are scheduled over here. So I don't need to worry about, you know, missing a particular class. That will never really happen with me. Okay, as you can see, all the classes are planned for me. I just click and I start attending the class. Okay, so that's how that works. Now, also for doing some interviews with podcast guests, I like to use Google Calendar, and I'll show you how that works out. So as you can see, I'll be doing a podcast interview with Noah Kagan soon, and this is what I have put up over here, right? So podcast with him, I've also emailed him about this, and we also have the Zoom link over here. So that's how that works out. Super helpful for me as a person who is doing a lot of meetings with people. I schedule everything over here. The to-do tasks I put up into my Notion, then I take it from there and I put it into my Google Calendar. Okay, that's how that works out. If you are wondering, how do I stay consistent? How do I stay productive? These two applications help me out a lot. Okay, Notion as well as Google Calendar. Now let's move on to the fifth application that I like to use, and this is going to be Spotify. Okay, now a lot of you already use Spotify, but I feel that I use it in a little bit different way. I'll just show you what I mean by that. Okay, so I'll just quickly open up Spotify, and I do two things on Spotify majorly. Okay, number one is to listening to podcasts, and number two is listening to audiobooks, right? So first of all, what I do is that I would go into, let's say I have this podcast right here. I will link in the description all of the podcasts that I like to listen to. You can choose any of these if that interests you. But this is one podcast that I listen. I would just like listen to them while I am going on a walk. Then I also like to look at some audiobooks, right? So audiobooks, I think, is really amazing. You can just like sit at one place, listen to an audiobook, write down your takeaways, and that will be really beneficial when you are looking back at them, let's say 1 month, 2 months, or even a year afterwards. So this is the audiobooks podcast, and they basically have all of the audiobooks that I like to listen to. Okay, so this is really helpful to me. I have listened to a bunch of audiobooks using this particular podcast. You can also look at some other ones, like you have Audiobook Earth. Basically, if you just search on Spotify for audiobooks, you will find a lot of these available podcast that will help you to listen to these audiobooks without paying, right? So this will be completely free. Just make sure that you buy the book afterwards just to support the author. That would be really important. You can find all of the important books that you would want to read over here. And that's how I like to use Spotify. I just listen to as many audiobooks as possible using this application. That is pretty much it. These were my five applications that I like to use. Number one was Notion. Number two is Canva or Adobe Spark Post. Number three is WazirX, Upstox, Grow, and some other investment related applications. Number four is going to be Google Calendar, super helpful for making me really productive throughout the day and getting stuff done. The final one would actually be Spotify. You can check out all of these applications. I'll be linking them in the description. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know if you have any questions, if you have any suggestions. You can also follow me on Instagram at ishansharma790. Comment down below and let me know what are your questions. You can also email me at ishan@marketup.in and I would love to answer back to your questions. Thank you so much. I am Ishan and I hope you enjoy this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.